Tonight, narrating the wonderful text that Stephen chose from some of our leading poets and authors will be Miss Shabazz and Paul Winfield.
American people a great challenge. He said at his second inauguration, with malice towards none, with charity for all, with firmness in the right as God gives us to see the right, let us strive on to finish the work we are in, to bind up the nation's wounds, to do all which may achieve and cherish a just and lasting peace amongst ourselves and with all nations.
There was nothing but land, not a country at all, but the materials out of which countries are made. I had the feeling that the world was left behind. The wagon jolted on, carrying me I knew not whither. If we never arrived anywhere, it did not matter. Between the earth and that sky, I felt erased, blotted out. I did not say my prayers that night. Here, I felt what would be. Your poor, your huddled masses, yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these homeless, tempest-tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.
And show me another city with lifted head, singing so proud to be alive and coarse and strong, flinging magnetic curses amid the toil of piling job on job. Here is a tall, bold slugger with ribs set vivid against little soft cities, bareheaded, shoveling, wrecking, planning, building, breaking, rebuilding, under the terrible burden of destiny, laughing as a young man laughs. Thank you.
away north, we thundered along starless tracks, through the fields and towns of a darkened republic. No more backwoods in barrios, no more humming how long, no more rocking in Jim Crow's cradle.
We've waited a long time for freedom. We're trying to remind the nation, now is the time to make real the promises of democracy. Now is the time.
We'll haul laundry and load coal until steel pours silver in an endless stream of chrome-lined dreams.
Of despair, a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jingling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. I have a dream today.
Almost there, we blink into the sun, put our collars to the wind, and step out into the bright noise of a century flexing its muscles.
With arms out straight, cloudscape of white below us, or a city glittering at night in a zodiac of wants. Thrown outward from earth as a digital spirit, the primate hand tilts wing-like from star to star, reaching encoded signals to find uncrossable spaces between galaxies and beyond, like a child running to fly, wind-like, winged mind. Sunlit silence hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through faultless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue, I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, where never lark or even eagle flew. And wild with silent, lifting mind, I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God. with malice towards none, with charity for all, with firmness in the right, as God gives us to see that right. Let us strive on to finish the work we are in, to bind up the nation's wounds, to do all which may achieve and cherish a just and lasting peace amongst ourselves and with all nations.
The bells are a clamor. Chives have been loosed. There is a banquet of hosannas in the air. We have endured endless peaks of pain and valleys of loneliness. We have lost beloveds we could not live without, yet we have lived. We have encountered unforgivable cruelties, yet we have forgiven. Yet we have been forgiven. We have survived, flourished, and thrived with passion, compassion, humor, and style. We have been fortunate and worthy. Now we stand heavy, laden before a great gate, which leads to the rest of all time. It swings ajar, and we know at this critical moment that not all we carry need enter when we enter. We can evict hate and scorn from our souls. We can open clenched fists and let bigotry, malice, and enmity fall back down the slope to yesterday. We can lay down our burden of violence and step lightly over the lintel into a vernal and newly minted tomorrow. We who have too soon shown our timidity, we who have too rarely shown our courage, can join the hallelujahs, the hymns, the paeans, the voices all over the world. We can shout or whisper, scream or mumble. I will ready my heart. I will prepare my soul.